Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. We'll start this week with Dell, which on Tuesday announced its plans to go private and be acquired by Michael Dell, the company's CEO and founder, and investment firm Silver Lake. The deal is valued at about $24.4 billion. Dell started in 1984 when Michael Dell started a company called PCs Limited with just $1,000. He changed the name to Dell and took the company public 4 years later. Over the years, Dell has acquired 25 companies, but has had a difficult time combining them into cohesive systems. In a statement, Michael Dell said, "I believe this transaction will open an exciting new chapter for Dell, our customers, and team members. We can deliver immediate value to stockholders while we continue the execution of our long-term strategy and focus on delivering best-in-class solutions to our customers as a private enterprise." The company's PCs and server hardware remains the core of its business for now. Dell has said it will stay in the PC market because it provides an entry point to selling other higher-margin products and services. Dell stockholders will receive $13.65 a share of Dell stock, which is a 25% premium on its closing share price on January 11th, which was when the rumors of a deal first appeared. After weeks of speculation, the European Commission presented new rules on cybersecurity across the EU. The main part of the Commission's cybersecurity strategy is a proposed directive on network and information security, and if approved by the European Parliament and member states, it would become EU law. Right now, only telecom companies are required to report significant security incidents. The new directive would extend that to major internet companies. Vice President of the European Commission in charge of digital agenda, Neelie Kroes, said business managers who deny cyber attacks are happening because they are worried about their reputation are not helping the situation.
We need to protect our networks and our systems and make them resilient. And that can only happen when all actors play their part and take up their responsibilities. Cyber threats are not contained to national borders, nor should cybersecurity be. So our strategy is accompanied by a proposed directive to strengthen cyber resilience within our single market. It will ensure companies take measures needed for safe and stable networks.
The proposed law comes on the heels of the January opening of the European Cybercrime Center. Based at The Hague in the Netherlands, the 30-person team will help protect European citizens and businesses from cybercrime. The EU this week also celebrated its 10th annual Safer Internet Day. In the EU, the average age for going online is 7 years old. The Commission is working with companies on a voluntary basis right now, but if improvements aren't made, then regulation and legislation will follow. Facebook, Google, Apple, and telecom companies have been cooperating. BlackBerry's Q10, one of the new handsets from the company, might not be available in the US until June. That's according to an Associated Press interview with CEO Torsten Hines. A June release would be 10 weeks later than the expected mid-March US release of the Z10. During the company's media event, Hines told reporters that some global carriers would be offering the Q10 in April. The exact release dates, though, will come from each wireless provider and will vary by market. The main difference between the two handsets is that the Z10 is touch-only with a 4.2-inch screen, while the Q10 has a touchscreen and QWERTY keyboard, a nod to the company's heritage and user base. The timing of the delivery of these phones is a concern for both corporate customers and BlackBerry investors, considering the already 18-month delay on the hardware. A further delay in shipments means that BlackBerry will have to contend with more competition, as Samsung is expected to launch the Galaxy S4 in March and Apple the next-gen iPhone in early summer. Sure, you can control your PC with your keyboard, mouse, sometimes even gestures, but how about your eyes? The system, developed by Fujitsu and already bundled into one of its PCs on sale in Japan, is based on a small camera and light embedded under the screen in this monitor, used to track eye movement.
So we have an infrared LED that emits infrared light, and then we have a camera that captures your face. And from there, we track your pupil, and we do a bunch of calculations and come back and say, okay, the user is looking at this point on the screen.
Not in the commercial version, this screen shows what the camera in the PC sees. It locates the user's pupil and a reference reflection from the infrared light, then determines eye movement by tracking the pupil as it moves relative to the reflection, which should stay still. It only requires about 20 seconds of setup for each user, and glasses or contact lenses shouldn't cause a problem. Last week at Macworld iWorld in San Francisco, we got to see some new ideas that might be coming to your smartphone or tablet sometime soon. There was this contraption, which is a bow blade to make iOS gaming apps more realistic. Or there was InJam, a new app that writes a unique song based on what you sing into it.
Every time I sing a song, oh, oh, yeah.
And so you just sing something like that, and then the little monkeys get to work and...
Every time I sing a song, every time I sing a song, InJam.
Users can share songs within the app, and the creators see it as sort of an Instagram of music. There's also Flint, which is a credit card capturing app, but it doesn't need any additional hardware like Square does. Instead, it does everything with a picture. Want to make your cat talk with Crazy Talk 7? You can do just about that and make any still image move however you like. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. As we head out, we'll leave you with some more shots from Macworld iWorld. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.